Do you want to make a DIY home decor piece, but you think that you should buy some new stuff? No, no, no. Without even buying with your scrap, you can do this. So these are the four wooden legs which I had from my old stool, and I thought I'll use this and create a beautiful home decor piece. Now to stick this, I am going to use my glue drops. This is going to make my work easier and faster. Now for sticking this, I'm not following the straight line technique. I'm just going to stick it a little randomly so that when I stick my embellishments, it pops out really well and this piece looks good. So here I'm using my glue drops, and I'm sticking all the four pieces together, and once it gets sticks really well, then I'm going to use my white acrylic paint. Now the base is really smooth and it is very light in shade, so I really don't have to use my gesso, and that's the reason I'm just directly applying my white color acrylic paint, and I'm going to have good two coats of acrylic paint on my base. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. The reason why you need to paint your base white is something which is really important in decoupage, and I've already done a video tutorial on that, so you can check on my channel the various videos on the tips and tricks of decoupage technique. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Now the base has dried out really well and it's time to add some colors to it, and for that I'm going to use this beautiful decoupage napkin which has some really beautiful cute little birds, and I'm going to mark the pieces which I want to use, and then I'm going to trim it off and I am going to remove all the plies before sticking that. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins. Now removing plies of your decoupage napkin is really important, so please do make sure that you remove the plies so that the actual color and the decoupage technique looks really good. Thank you. Now it's time to stick these birds, and for that I'm going to use my Mod Podge, and I have a flat brush with that. I'm going to stick this on my base, and as because my napkins are really small, sticking them is super easy and they look super cute. Yes, I'm going to have some of the birds on the front and a couple of birds on the sides too, so that from the sides also the piece looks really complete and beautiful. Mod Podge has dried out really well, and it's time to add some more color. So I will be using chalk paint and stencils, and I will be adding some banana pale green color, yellowish color, and this pink color, and I'll be using some stencils. This is completely optional. You can even do some stamping, you can even add some more decoupage napkins, you can even do and play around just with the colors, and they are also going to look really fab. But here I actually have a big collection of stencils, and I love using them. So I will be using a couple of stencils here for this project. Now when I'm using my chalk paints, I'm using my sponge dauber, and this is a very thin sponge dauber. Now the reason why I'm using my sponge dauber is because my project is a little smaller, the blocks are a little smaller, the niches are really smaller, so I need to make sure that my colors comes to all the thick and thins and the corners of the project. Now when I'm using my peach color, I am going to make sure that I am using my colors on the borders also. This is actually going to highlight the block, and that is actually going to highlight my each alphabets and the embellishments which I am going to use at the end. I love wooden alphabets, and this is one of the cute piece of work which I am doing. So here I am using my chalk paint, and I am going to let it dry completely. Now the chalk paint, when they dries out, they are completely matte, and when you do stamping on it, nothing like it. They are just amazing. So here, once they dried out completely, then I'm going to use my script stamp, and I'm going to use my permanent ink pad, and I'm going to stamp this. But before doing my stamping, I'm going to make sure that I have aligned it in a straight line so that it looks a little symmetrical when I have sticked it. Bonheur est passé, à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins.
que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, souvenir impossible à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, souvenir impossible à effacer.
Finally, it's time to add some embellishments and my wooden letters. So here I've decided to do this offline, some in a zigzag pattern so that it looks a little different and nice. And I'm using my liquid adhesive for this. So I will be sticking some shiny stones and paper flowers to complete this project.
À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, souvenir impossible à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins.
Now I need to fill up the cover, the center portion of each block so that there is no gap and it sticks really well. So I'm just adding my liquid adhesive. This is just an additional layer of protection so that it does not comes out. To finish this project, I need to have my varnish, and the glittery varnish is going to look just fab. So here I'm adding my glitter to my varnish, and I'm going to do a complete good one coat of varnish with the glitter. Yes, later on I am also going to do my clear varnish, that is going to be just the plain varnish on the top of it. It's for my extra sealing purpose. And with this, my project is done. This is how beautiful, shiny and colorful my project looks, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Yes, I have listed down all the supplies down in the description.